Hello, folks. How are we doing? Happy Sunday to you. Today is the 13th day of November 2022. I had to think about it for a second. It is bright and early on a Sunday. What time is it? 7:39 and partly sunny down here in Tampa, Florida. So I got to take an L on this one. I got to do this quick video and show you. I got something wrong. Oh my God. It's only happened once before, and it happened once when I thought I was wrong. But I was wrong. Anyway, so the other day, I was flexing on you. I know. I went to the store, and I did something out of character for me. I got myself some Gevalia coffee. And I was flexing on you guys like $8 a fucking... It's not even a pound, is it? 12 ounces. It's not even a pound. $8. I was flexing on you guys. I was like, oh, it's good coffee. I'm so happy I got myself some good coffee. One of you fuckers out there... say, God damn, Scott. We can't let you go out like that. Like poor white trash. Thinking you got some good coffee from fucking Walmart. So one of you fuckers out there, all of a sudden I got a box. I know who it's from. Thank you so much. I got a box. I got a box in, sitting on my door yesterday, and in it is this. I don't know if you'll ever be able to. I turn this off, maybe. That didn't help at all. Ah, fuck. I'll just read it to you. It's Arvid Norquist Classic Milan. It is coffee. It is fucking really, really good coffee. Really good coffee. So one of you guys is like, Scott, God damn it. You're showing your poor white trash roots are showing again. So one of you motherfuckers sent me some real coffee. And I have to say thank you so very much for this. Sometimes, you know what? Sometimes it's fun to be. Sometimes it's good to be reminded you're just poor white trash. I could do this whole video just sitting here like this. Like a horse with his little fucking feeding thing on. It's like a, it's like an inhalation fucking mukbang. God damn, this is good coffee. Swedish? Dutch? I'm not exactly sure. But I did look it up, and I am exactly sure that I can't afford any more of it. God damn, that's good coffee. Thank you so much. It actually has it's got a little green fucking seal on it. Here. It's got a little green seal on it, and it's in two places. It's actually in two places. And it's that means that it's carbon neutral. I have carbon neutral, which might be why it's expensive, but I have carbon neutral coffee. Now I haven't, you know, drank that much of it since yesterday. How many ounces is this? Because that's, oh God, it's so nice. It's in grams. Oh my fucking God. I'm such poor white trash. It's amazing. how do you fucking survive, Scott? I don't fucking know. How do you get out of bed in the morning? I don't know. I got one
thing.
You know, the poor white trash C-League coffee, at least they give you these little things, right? And you can seal your bag. The good coffee... they're like, fuck you. Go out and get a fucking... go out and get a paper clip, you dick. They don't give you nothing to seal it with, but they tell you on the side, you better seal this shit up. So, did I get rid of that much? No. Did I palm the rest of it? No. I put it in this thing, which is airtight, and I'll just use that. Decanter there. I didn't have any reason for any use for this, so... now I've got my brown gold in it. That shit's more expensive than heroin, especially these days. like in Philadelphia. You buy heroin on the street for like some bottle caps. Like this shit was fucking Fallout. Thank you. Thank you so much. Very, very good coffee. I'm enjoying some right now. You'll notice I'm not using my ceramic cup for this. I like coffee in glass. I like a good coffee in glass. So, someone told me, Aunt Bibi told me, I was telling her about this. She goes, yeah, well, that's good, but it's kind of not. And I'm like, what do you mean it's not? She's like, well, it's good that you have some really, really nice coffee, but you're never going to be able to afford it again. So from now on, when you drink this, which you thought was good coffee, it's now going to be shit. Somebody has fucking cursed me. Cursed me. Curses. Okay, that's fine. But would have I gotten this far in life if I had ever thought about the future? No. So fuck it. I'm going to enjoy it now. Day or what tomorrow. There you go. How you guys doing? I'm not going to be doing Coach Moth Pill today for you. I'm just going to take my L and be done with it. So I've been telling you on BitChute and videos and stuff here that obviously the system is rigged with a capital rigged. We know that. And I was showing you the results and the fact that we were waiting for now Georgia in the runoff and Nevada and Arizona. And I said, they're probably going to drag it out to see what happens in Georgia before they decide on what they're going to do. Wrong. They gave Arizona to the fucking Dems 2 days ago. And in spite of the fact that the Senate candidates, in spite of the fact the Republican Senate candidate was leading in Nevada, last night, late, they gave the Nevada Senate seat to the Dem. She came out of nowhere, miraculously, from behind, and won. Isn't it fascinating that all of these fucking votes coming in after the election just happened to be going for the Dems? What a fucking coincidence. Republicans don't use the mail-in ballot system, Scott. Why not? Don't Republicans have things to do in their lives? Take a look at this. So that's the new fucking newness. Look at that. The Dems are now up to 204 seats in the fucking House. The Republicans are still at 211. How long have they been at 211? Quite a while. Since Friday. They haven't moved an inch. Here is the video I did on Friday talking about this seat in Nevada. And as you can see, the Republican was well ahead by a little over 1,000, a little under 1,000. And the votes just keep rolling in, and boom! All of a sudden now, the Democrat wins in Nevada, and it goes blue. Funny thing happened on the way to the mailbox. Let me see if I can pull up on that other one real quick. A breakdown of the House. So I can show you. Yeah, here you go. They were at 194 for the Dems in the House and 211 for the Republicans in the House. 204 for the Democrats in the House, 211 for Republicans in the House. And that started way back when they were 189, 193 to 211. It's like they're only counting blue ballot votes. Don't know how that works. But my thing was, I was expecting them to wait until Georgia. Maybe something happened. And they know that Herschel Walker is going to end up winning that thing. And we'll be back to 50-50 again, with the tie-in vote being cast by Kamala Harris. Jesus. That's what I fully expected them to wait on, just to see what happened, because who knows. However, guess not. And if things keep going the way they're going, it looks like they're going to end up getting to 218 in the House before the fucking Republicans do. They'll control the House, the Senate, and the fucking White House again. That's something I really didn't expect them to do. I'm not going to say that's not what I expected us, the voters to do, because it's clearly not in the hands of the voters anymore in this country, is it? Anyway, another thing I wanted to talk briefly about is Dave Chappelle. I loved Dave Chappelle. Dave Chappelle's funny. He was very funny. Is it just me, or does it look like Dave Chappelle's been doing the human growth hormone? Because it damn sure looks like his head is about as big as fucking Barry Bonds is now. And he's just, you know, he was thin when he was, and I know people change a bit, but you know, he was thin when he was, you know, actually Dave Chappelle back in the day when he had the Chappelle Show, and was very funny. I want to show you a little bit of a difference in Dave Chappelle. Maybe I'm acting a little weirder because I actually have real coffee with real caffeine. I don't care about tomorrow. I just care about enjoying today. If anybody in Sweden or Norway or whoever who makes this, if you're looking for a video content creator on YouTube to sponsor, I got an email from somebody. I thought maybe it was some kind of spam or some kind of virus, but there's no link. They're not telling me to go talk to anybody. They're not telling me to reply. And there's no attachment. There's not even a fucking... it's Netflix. And somebody... Netflix... Something team. I guess they do animation or something on Netflix. And they said, because of my every now and then on YouTube, I put in, I'm going to do some today, video game playing stuff in between my political stuff. And apparently, their AI, their fucking thing, picked it up. And they sent me an email saying, yours is the kind of YouTube channel we want to be associated with. And I was like, what? No. You guys do not know me. I would never want to belong to a club that would have somebody like myself as a member. Who said that? And that is the goddamn truth. Anyway. So I just thought that was funny. I loved Dave Chappelle. I don't anymore. And I haven't since his return. I just told people, and everyone looks at me and goes, it's Dave Chappelle. But I've told people repeatedly, he just seems different. And I don't want to put it this way, because Paul Newman in Cool Hand Luke being beat down on the fucking road crew, on the chain gang by Big Boss Man, was cultural appropriation enough? Yeah, that happened to some white folks back in the day, but the whole, if you look at the chain gang, it was supposedly in like Georgia or some shit. I think it was like three black people and a whole bunch of, you know, guys who would think this is good coffee. So it was cultural appropriation enough just to fucking make the fucking movie, but still a good movie. But when he's down in the pit and he's broken and he's like, I got my mind right, boss. And boss is like, you're not going to backslide. No, I'm not going to backslide. You're not going to backtalk. No, I'm not going to backtalk. It's a great moment, and you don't really know whether or not he's still playing, you know, the cool hand character, you know, the character still playing him, or if he's actually means it. And I hate to say it, but it damn sure sounds like fucking Dave Chappelle did that. And now we're talking about Kanye. I did a video about Kanye yesterday, and I've done a video talking about Kyrie and saying the day after, people are like, the list of stuff that Kyrie is now being forced to do by the NBA and by fucking commissioner of the NBA. The list of stuff, Adam Silver, the list of stuff was a bridge too far for all these people. And by these people, I don't mean black people. By these people, I mean people who now all of a sudden want to stand up in support of Kyrie. The day after this shit happened, and several days before the apology and then the list, I came out and said the NBA and the Brooklyn Nets have absolutely no fucking right to suspend Kyrie Irving. If you believe in the Civil Rights Act, if you believe in the First Amendment, if you believe in the freedom of religion in this country, then he has a fucking right to say whatever the fuck he wants to say. And everyone's like, well, Scott, it's a business. And so the business is allowed to do that because it could cost the business money. Quick fucking history lesson. The Civil Rights Act was not brought about because government was saying black people couldn't sit at the front at the lunch counter in the window. Government wasn't saying black people couldn't belong, even though they could afford it. Some of them, few of them back then, couldn't belong to a fucking country club. That wasn't government that was doing that to African Americans and black people back then. It was businesses. The lunch counter people said, white people walk past the window, they see a black person at the counter, they keep walking, it hurts our business. The fucking country club says, black person comes in, signs on the dotted line, pays his fucking dues, pays his monthly thing, grabs his clubs, goes out there. White people are going to look at that and go, I don't want to be part of this, and they're going to cancel their shit and leave. It's going to cost them money. The Civil Rights Act said, you can't do that. Businesses cannot discriminate against people by the color of their skin, by their religious beliefs. It was added, their sexuality, because they say it's going to end up costing them money. No. And we've just slowly but surely been guided along, led by the fucking nose to go, oh yeah, well, it's a business. Businesses can do that. If you say that about the fucking Nets, then you say that about your local lunch counter. When you go and you sit at the local lunch counter and they look you in the eye and they say, we don't serve your kind up here. You need to go sit back in the back where the people walking by can't see you. You have got no fucking right to be angry about that. And that's a fact. That was my argument the day after it happened. Now all these people are jumping on board talking about the fact that that was too many. He was saying do this and do that. He'd already apologized. He'd already cost him $500,000 in donation and five fucking game paychecks, which is again 1.2 million total. I'm posting a link to a video. They never had a right to do any of that to him. And in fact, the ones who should be called out for being morally insufficient are the ADL, the NBA, the Nets specifically, and every goddamn newscaster and NBA player, former and current, who don't stand up and didn't stand up to start with to stand with Kyrie. And you can say, well, Scott, that's hindsight. Go, my video's still up. Go look at it. Do I agree with his point of view? With black people are the real Jews and Jews are the interlopers who have stolen the Jewishness from the Jewish heritage from the black. No, I don't give a fuck. But it's his right. It's his right to say it. I told you, I have my own First Amendment fucking lawsuit. I never gave in to it. Never paid him a nickel. I stuck to my fucking guns. And they had a multi-billion dollar fucking law firm working for this guy to get me, Derek Wilbon, Alan West, Alex Jones, the guy from fucking Gateway Pundit, Lee Stranahan, to get us all to fucking learn to keep our mouths shut. They had to pay. I didn't. And I told him, I said, all these other people are going to settle. And that's going to leave your client, a plaintiff, and you, a billion-dollar law firm, to pay all this money to drag my poor, poor white trash ass, former carpenter, former draftsman, disabled blogger, to federal fucking court. And I'll do it. And you know damn well I'll do it. And I know for a fact your company ain't gonna pay all that money to sue my dumb ass. I used the poor white trash defense. And it worked. God damn. Anyway, I say all that so I can say this. His take on the fucking situation, he's trying to dance through it. Dave Chappelle last night, Saturday Night Live. He's trying to dance through it to start with, but he's really saying if you come to, at one point he literally says this, if you come to fucking Hollywood and you see all these Jewish people in powers of position, and you come to the delusional conclusion that Jews control Hollywood, then just whatever you do, don't say it. But he said it was delusional. You know, he's got his mind right. And not just on that topic. He also later did this thing about, oh, I was so surprised. All these Ukrainian service members, they are awesome fighters. And there was applause from the left-leaning crowd. They're just awesome fighters. We didn't realize how great of fighters they were. He's literally talking about fucking Nazis, praising fucking Nazis. 9 minutes. After giving Kyrie and Kanye shit about saying delusional things about the Jews in Hollywood. Let that sink in for a second. He supports Jewish people. He backs Jewish people. He says all this shit. And then he literally praises how wonderful the fighters are, the Nazi fighters are in fucking Ukraine. And he meant it. Not only did he do that,
Democrat, I'm telling you, as soon as he won, they started saying all that he's colluding with Russia, he's colluding with Russia. It was very embarrassing as a Democrat, but as time went on, we all came to learn he was probably colluding with Russia.
No. No, I'm not a fucking Trump fan. But there has been no fucking evidence that he was colluding with Russia. And more importantly, there's no evidence that Russia was colluding with him. There's been none. He's just a tool of theirs now. And that's the saddest fucking thing. To wrap this video up, I will remind you of what it was that got Dave Chappelle kicked off, canceled in the first place. Remember, when he did this, not 4 years ago, when he did this, Bush was still fucking in office.
If the United States goes to war with Iraq, will it first have to provide evidence that Saddam Hussein has weapons of mass destruction? So far, the UN has found nothing. But President Bush counters with this.
The nigga bought aluminum tubes. Do I need to tell you what the f- you can do with an aluminum tube? Aluminum! They don't scare you? Fine. I didn't want to say this. The motherfucker bought some yellow cake, okay, in Africa. He went to Africa and he bought yellow cake.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure, bitch. I got the head of the CIA right here, okay?
Are you sure?
Black head of the CIA.
Ridiculous. Me and Jeb just coming back from Africa. Cradle of civilization. This nigga out here buying yellow cake.
Jeb Black, Jeb Bush.
Are you sure it was yellow cake?
Y'all niggas don't believe me. I got some yellow cake right here. Look, see? Drop that. No, I know what to do with it. So I got it wrapped up in this special CIA napkin.
Drop that. Yeah.
Now listen, that's the shit he did. I mean, it got worse. It got worse. I'll post a link. You can go watch Black Bush. Dave Chappelle was scathing, and he understood the role, not only of comedians, but also of the media, to hold the powerful to account, not to prop up the powerful when they're being exposed at moments of weakness, which is what he's doing. It's depressing to me. It's sad to me. I don't know why I threw that in there. Maybe because I'm all jacked on the fucking on real coffee. It's been a while since I had real coffee. It is so good. Sundays are usually a little more relaxed in terms of my videos. Anyway, so sad about Dave Chappelle. He was very, very funny. Do you see what I'm talking about? I mean, his head is bigger, his neck is bigger. He's obviously, you know, put on some fucking weight. And not the way that, you know, older men put on weight like I do. He's bulked up. So I don't know. A lot of them are doing that now. Look at the older guys. Look at Sean Penn. You see Sean Penn? He wears that T-shirt and he's got his arms flexing when he's, you know, in a picture, trying to hand an Oscar over to a fucking war criminal. And he's got to flex his arms so you can see his muscles. I tell you, these fuckers, they're all taking human growth hormone. They're all taking testosterone replacement therapy. And they're all just waiting for enough of the mRNA fucking testing regime to the point where they get to where they can say, you know what, we can halt cell aging. We can halt aging. They're just waiting. They're hanging in there. They're doing the best they can to get as young looking as possible, just in case they can't reverse aging, but they can certainly halt it. So that's what they're doing. And we're sitting here watching them do it. And drinking very good coffee while we're watching. But she's right. Aunt Bibi's right. Once this is all gone, I'll be very sad. I'll be like a junkie with an empty bag. All right. So There you go. That's my L. I took an L. I admit it. I thought that they were going to drag this thing out. Apparently, they said, to hell with it. Let's just go ahead and take both the House and the Senate in spite of and just throw it in everybody's fucking face. Yeah, we'll just keep counting and counting and counting and counting and counting until we get the results, the one we want. It's remarkable. And the fact that people just sit around and say nothing about it is depressing. It really is. I'm going to go out and have an interesting Sunday, and I hope you guys do the same. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll talk to you later. That is Bo saying adios. I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.